Welcome to this segment on behavioral activation presented by the Stanford Geriatric Education Center. What we're going to show you here will be five short takes of what would typically occur in a mental health provider's office with an older adult client. The client that we're working with today is Maria. Maria is 68, she's widowed, she is of Latino descent, and she lives with her oldest daughter. Maria has been depressed for a while. She's been referred by her primary care provider for mental health treatment because she didn't really respond well to antidepressant medications. Maria also has significant medical problems, the most important of which is poorly controlled type 2 diabetes. She's very worried that this diabetes is somehow going to lead her to get dementia, and this is part of her depression, worrying about the future. So Maria has said that in the first interview with her, she has said that she doesn't do much anymore. She just kind of hangs around the house, does the minimum of what she has to do, but doesn't really enjoy things very much. In our second meeting, we set some goals for the cognitive behavior therapy that she's engaging in. And the first goal was to help her get more active because she realizes that lying around the house and not really doing much and not getting much enjoyment must be contributing to her depressed mood. So she realizes that and she's willing to work on that. So that's our first therapy goal. So Maria is here now for her third appointment. And at this third appointment, we're going to start out. Maria, it's good to see you again today.
It's good to see you also, Dr. Thompson.
Well, I know that you've been filling out the PHQ-9. Could you let me see it, please?
Yes.
Okay. We use the PHQ-9, you know, to get a sense of whether or not what we're doing is helping you. Okay, so it's good that you took the time before we met to fill this out. So your score is pretty high. It's still right around 18. And that suggests that you're still very depressed, which is reasonable because we're just really starting the treatment.
Okay.
Right? But let me take that and file it, and then next week we'll give it to you again. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. So last week we talked about your goal, and the first goal being to help you get more active, mm-hmm. right? And do you remember why we said that that was an important thing to get more active, how that might affect your depression?
Well, I think because you asked me if I was doing pleasurable activities, I think is a term you use,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of things that used to make me happy before, I don't do anymore. Mm-hmm. I just kind of stay around the house and mope.
Mm-hmm.
And you said that by me moving, it would help me feel a little bit better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really good. You really understand the reasoning, you know, why mm-hmm. we're doing this. And I just like to look again at our model here, the drawing that we looked at last week, just to remind you and also to help me, help us get focused on what we're mm-hmm. looking at. So in cognitive behavior therapy, we're really looking at the relationship, how thoughts affect our feelings, right? How what we think affects what we do.
Mm-hmm.
And then our thinking may also affect our physical well-being. You know, I know you're worried about your diabetes, mm-hmm. and sometimes the thoughts can get in the way of taking good care of yourself physically. But because your main goal right now is to get more active, we're not going to begin by working on thoughts. We're going to start over here. We're going to work on your behaviors or your actions.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because actions and behavior, what we do every day, also affects our thoughts, okay? It also affects our feelings, and it can also affect our physical well-being. So if you're more active, you might start to feel better physically.
Mm-hmm.
So does that make sense that by starting here, we're going to influence all of these other things in the approach? And then when we finish this part, we'll go over to here.
Yes, I just have problems getting started.
Yeah, okay. So I think this is really the right place to begin then. Mm-hmm. And the, what I'd like to do with you is called behavioral activation. So let me write that up here so that you know what it's called. This is the approach that we'll use, behavioral activation, and it means helping you figure out ways to bring more enjoyment into your everyday life. Okay?
Okay.
And the way we start with an activity log. So let me give you this. And this is something we're going to need to work on a little bit together here in the in this meeting. So this activity log, you can see it has the days of the week across the top, and then it has the time of day going down the page. And this, actually, we need two pages, right? Because it ends, we can't fit it all on one page. So what I'll do is I'll tape these two pages together so that you have them and you'll find it maybe a little bit easier that way to work with them. What we do is we ask you to put in for every block, every square there, what you did. So it's pretty straightforward. It's just a record of what you did. And then we ask you to also give a mood rating.
Okay.
How did it make you feel when you did that particular thing? So, and the mood rating goes from 1 to 10, where the 1 means not very much, didn't make me feel good, my mood was down. 5 is the middle, that means so-so. Anything above 5, so
you
6.
Number 3 is so-so.
Oh, that's a mistake. Yeah, it should be, thank you for telling me. It should be number 5. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, number 5 is so-so. And then number 10 means your mood is very good. So okay. Anything from 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 means good. And 1, 2, 3, 4 means not so good.
And then
the 5 is kind of in the middle. Okay?
Okay.
So I'd like us to start right now in this appointment today to fill out the log so you get an idea how to do it. All right, so could we think about yesterday? Could you tell me what was your day like yesterday? What time did you get up? You can fill that in there. What time did you get up, Maria?
I'm kind of embarrassed because I tend to sleep a lot. And so I don't end up getting up till around 10 or 11 sometimes.
Uh-huh. Well, that's okay. We want you to be honest.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I see that you start at 6 in the morning. And
well, some people can't sleep, so they get up really early.
Okay.
Yeah. But if your usual time is 10 o'clock, would you put it in that box, please?
And I just write,
woke up.
Woke
mm-hmm.
up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and does that give you any enjoyment to wake up, or are you kind of, not looking forward to the day when you wake up?
Honestly, not looking forward to the day.
Okay. So on this scale that we have, how would you rate that? What number would you give it?
A 1 or a 2.
Okay, so let's put that in there also to remind you, okay? So I want us to go through the whole day, all right? So you wake up around 10, and then what do?
Then I make my way to the kitchen, and I try to get some coffee.
Mm-hmm. So do you have anything to eat? Do you fix breakfast?
No, I usually check my blood sugar.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And some days I do and some days I don't. It's kind of like I don't want to know what my blood sugar is.
Yeah. Yeah. So you get some things to get the day going. You do some things to get the day going.
Yes.
So you make coffee, right? And you check your blood sugar sometimes. Mm-hmm. Did you check it yesterday?
Yes.
Okay, so let's put that down. And when you check your blood sugar, is that associated with any feelings, like negative or positive feelings? Does it kind of depend on what the reading is?
Well, if my sugar's over 200, I just, okay. I mean, I actually, I feel bad. Mm-hmm. If I get under 150, I feel good.
And what was it yesterday?
It was 210.
Okay, so let's write that down. The blood sugar level was 210, and then that made you feel not so good, right? Mm-hmm. So how would you rate that on that scale?
Probably, again, a 1 or a 2.
A 1 or a 2, okay.
I wish it was better.
Okay. And then what did you do after that?
Got my I gave myself my, took my medications, mm-hmm. and my insulin and my coffee, and then I tried to read the paper or turn on the TV.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So was that up until, say, lunchtime?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So would you put that in there? Okay. So you read the paper, watched some TV. And how about lunch? Because that would probably be the first time you're eating then, would be around lunchtime.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So did you have any lunch yesterday?
Yes.
Okay.
I scrambled an egg, and mm-hmm. I had a tortilla with some salsa.
Ah, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Now, when you had lunch, did you feel a little better?
Well, I didn't want to check my sugar because I knew it was high.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that the tortilla, I don't know how that works in me, but sometimes I don't want to know. Mm-hmm. So I just think if I eat that amount, it's going to bring my sugars down.
Mm-hmm. So you felt maybe so-so, maybe mm-hmm. that number 5?
The number 5.
All right, so let's put lunch down there. And then in the afternoon, what did you do?
I don't do much. I can't. Mm-hmm. I don't even have the energy to do anything. I kind of want to go back to sleep.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I remember that you mentioned last time that you probably were going to have a doctor's appointment yesterday. So, did you keep your doctor's appointment
mm-hmm.
yesterday?
That was at 3:00.
Okay. And what was that like? What's it like when you go to see your doctor? How does that make you feel?
It just makes me realize that how important it is for me to try and keep myself healthy,
mm-hmm.
because I'm worried that I may get that illness where you forget things.
Dementia, like you said.
Yes, yeah. And so I get really worried about that, and
mm-hmm.
but it's hard for me.
So what's your mood like when you go to the doctor? Do you remember yesterday? What did you feel like? What was your mood like?
Nervous, anxious, a mm-hmm. little upset at myself.
Okay, so let's write that down. So you had your doctor's appointment, and maybe your mood wasn't depressed, but it was more anxious. So just mm-hmm. write that in there, because we want it to be accurate. And then you got home, and probably, did you help your daughter fix dinner?
Well, she was home. Teal asked me to like chop onions or tomatoes mm-hmm. or whatever mm-hmm. she's going to make. And so I kind of help with the chopping.
Uh-huh. Okay. And that's good. You look like you kind of look like you enjoy that.
It takes an effort, but I enjoy it. Yes.
Okay. So let's get that down. So that's about what, maybe 5:00? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you're you're helping fix dinner.
Helping fix dinner.
Mm-hmm. And it sounds like that mood, at that time, your mood maybe is a little better.
About a 5.
About a 5, okay. And what do you do after dinner?
Sit down, watch TV.
Mm-hmm.
Relax.
Okay. And is that enjoyable?
Yeah, I like watching TV.
Okay. Did you have any favorite shows that you watched?
Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, you like that?
I like that program.
Yeah. Mm. And that is Monday nights, right?
Yes, it
is.
Yeah.
Okay. So that brought a smile to your face. So that seemed like it was enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
So let's put that down. So you watched the show, and I think that's on around, what, 8:00?
8:00.
Something
uh-huh.
like that. Okay.
I guess it's...
And did your sister come over, too? I know you said she sometimes visits in the evening.
She called and just checking in on me, and so it was a brief conversation, and so she was tired as well, but I'm glad she's nearby.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. She's really close to me.
I see a little smile there, too.
Yeah, she's really close to me.
So could you write that down then? That's probably the last thing that happened, or is that the last thing before you went to bed?
Yeah, I was in bed by 10 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. And how would you rate the conversation with your sister?
Seven.
Hmm, okay, so that was high. And the TV, Dancing with the Stars, that mm-hmm. was, what, an eight, I think you have there? Yeah, okay. So, good. Thank you, Maria. Now, let's take a minute and see what we can learn from this, okay? Because what I'm going to ask you to do before our next appointment is to fill in the rest of the days, okay? Just like we did it here. So, pretty much every hour, what you did and what your mood was like, whether you were enjoying what was happening or it was so-so or it wasn't good at all, okay? But let's see what we can learn from this. So one thing that strikes me is that most of the time, your mood is either a five or less. You know, it's pretty low most of the time, but it picks up around dinner time. So dinner, making dinner, I think, well, that was a five also, yeah. So it actually, your mood didn't pick up until you watched the show that you liked, mm-hmm. and then your sister called. So those are two things that it looks like you enjoy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's see during this week that's coming up now, if you can try to do those more consistently. Watch some shows that you enjoy and talk to your sister. Okay, would you be willing to do that?
Okay, so just for my part, make an effort to call her and...
Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. or vice versa. Okay, I can do that.
So I'm really asking you to do two things. Okay, one is to finish the log, complete this for the week, and then the second is to see if you could increase the number of times that those particular things happen, the things that you identified as really enjoyable. Okay. And I'm going to ask you one more question, and then we'll be done for today, and that is, how confident are you that you can really do this homework? You know, confidence, like your degree of... The sense that you have that, yes, I can get this done, I can fill out the form, I can try to increase those couple of things.
Well, it gives me something to do. I mean, because I kind of don't have anything to do. I kind of mope around the house. And so I think I can, at least I'll have something to do mm-hmm. other than feel like I'm not doing nothing. At least,
okay.
You know,
at least you have this to fill out. All right.
So I can focus on that.
Okay. So, you know, sometimes it helps if you think about when you might fill it out and where you can keep the form so that it'll be easy for you to access it. So do you think you might fill it out as you go along during the day, or you think you'll fill it out at the end of the day?
I tend to be very forgetful. Sometimes mm-hmm. I don't remember what happened 10 minutes ago. So I think I'll keep it on the counter and just check the time and, mm-hmm. and just fill it in as I go.
Try to do it as the day goes along. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think that's great, Maria. So I hope that you will be able to do the assignment, and I look forward to seeing you next week.
Yeah. Thank you for calling me by my middle name.
You're welcome.